Certainly Swindon caught napping at the 16th minute corner kick by Millwall. Digby, Fraser Digby does well there to block McCleary's shot, but Tony Cascarino picks up the goal. No marks to him for that gesture to Swindon supporters, but the Millwall fans loved that goal from...
Again, Cowans tries to step up the tempo. McGrath. Still McGrath. Too long. Cowans keeps it. Flat. One back. One back by Cascarino. Sheer weight of numbers produces some reward for Villa. And they're still in this game. Cowans keeping the ball alive. Good athletic header by Platt. Cascarino reacts quickest. And Tony Cascarino, whose return on a £1.5 million fee has not been exceptional, gets one important goal back for Villa now. York.
Beckman with the pass back to Cascarino, and he equalises for Celtic. 70 minutes, Cascarino's been in the field only a few moments. A nightmare of a pass back there from Beckman. There seemed to be no trouble at all for Rangers. There was Cascarino scoring only his second goal for Celtic. It was Tommy Coyne with the downward header. Beckman with the pass back, Cascarino reacting immediately and sending the ball into the back of the net. Rangers 1, Celtic 1.
Cascarino, yes, the equaliser, 3 minutes from full-time.
Crosses by Clark, Cascarino! And West Ham
is here. Wise against Cundy. Clark had made a run, missed him out. Spencer challenges for it. Cascarino might get a second one. He's still in here. Spencer, and he's gone in. It's gone in. It's two for Chelsea. They look, Spurs look to the referee. Mr. Ellery says it's a goal, and Chelsea are two up.
Well, unfortunately for Tottenham there, and the ball comes in. It's another good crossing from Dennis Wise here, and they were in total disarray when they didn't clear the first header. They've got opportunity, Dean Austin doesn't get a good header on it. Now there's still two white shirts around there. It looks as though Cascarino has three white shirts there. A little fortunate with the bounce. And yes, it's Cascarino's goal, he gets to...
Barnard. Good ball. Keeper came and missed it, Chelsea back in it. Cascarino...
Oh là là.
Ouais, ah oui, super, Ferreri.
Vous l'avez entendu,
c'est bien joué.
C'est très bien joué, oui.
Ferreri, en plein baume, Cascarino, deux fois, but, en deux temps, oh là 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 là, extraordinaire, Ferreri, Cascarino, les dieux de l'Olympe sont marseillais. Ah, quelle belle pyramide, pyramide de joie, pyramide d'orgueil, 3-0 face au leader du championnat de Grèce.
Malgré l'arrêt de Tauroglou, mais il y avait eu un festival Ferreri avant ce troisième but marseillais. Le second pour le compte de Cascarino. Petite roulette, il lève la tête, feinte de frappe. Et balle en retrait, l'arme absolue. Un coup pour rien pour Cascarino et le second coup, c'est au fond.
Michel, où ils vont chercher cette énergie.
Et toujours ces longs ballons dans la surface de réparation pour Tony Cascarino. Quelle protection de balle de l'Irlandais.
Marcel Dib.
Ah, c'est bien joué ça, ouais.
C'était pas en jeu.
Et bien voilà. Ouais. L'ouverture du score après 20 minutes de jeu. Signé Tony Cascarino, c'est pas de la tête, c'est du pied.
We'll be right back. Le sauveur irlandais de Nancy, c'est donc lui, Tony Cascarino. À Marseille, il ne jouait plus depuis la montée en première division. Nancy, bien mal en point, lui a tendu les bras juste avant Noël. Il n'a pas hésité. Quelques jours plus tard, il inscrit 3 buts au Havre pour le dernier match de l'année 96. Le voilà déjà coqueluche du club. Côté ville, Tony n'est pas encore installé. Pendant la trêve, il est rentré en Angleterre. En ce moment, je suis en plein déménagement. Tout est encore très nouveau pour moi ici. Je suis surpris, c'est une très belle ville. J'ai été agréablement surpris par Nancy. Cascarino, l'international irlandais amoureux de la France, a donc adopté Nancy. Au club des supporters, on attend sa photo et on fait connaissance.
Alors, 3 au Havre, plus 3 samedi, d'accord?
3 samedi? Fini.
Après, non, ça continuera.
Ça y est, Tony est maintenant chez lui. Il a définitivement enfilé le maillot nancéen.
Cascarino in there again. Adams read that very well indeed for England. A nasty bounce of the ball beat David Platt. Staunton plays it in again towards Tony Cascarino.
Capable of taking 2 points here, nonetheless, as they're serious contenders for World Cup qualification. With less than 14 minutes of normal time remaining here in Tirana, can they do it this time? Maybe from the set piece. He goes high. Cascarino gets the header. It's in the goal. Tony Cascarino. Keeper furious with the referee, claiming he was having a short pull, but the referee waving him away. I think Tony Cascarino has come up with the bacon for Ireland. No question about that.
Sommer, plötzlich 4 Iren gegen 4 Deutsche. Gut gemacht von McAteer.
Und Cascarino, Tor! Zum ersten Mal ist der Tony Cascarino frei. Wie der Kalle gesagt hat, ein klassischer Strafraumspieler. Alle Duelle vor dem 16-Meter-Raum hat Jürgen Kohler bis dahin gegen Cascarino.
Tor. Deutscher Verteidiger.
Gut gemacht von McAteer.
Ja. Thomas Schwanz hat unglücklich verlängert den Ball und dadurch kommt der Kohler ganz einfach nicht mehr an den Ball.
Dimitrescu is coming on.
He's up.
Loose ball and a goal. Cascarino.
Goal number 7 in World Cup qualifying for Cascarino. He has tied it.
Well, once again, Kennedy's the man who floats it across. There's a couple of opportunities here for the ball to be cleared out. Nicely played forward by Babb, and Cascarino puts the bulge in the corner of the O'Longian bag. Brilliant diving header. This is just pure opportunism. Babb plays it inside. Watch the back header, and Cascarino nails it. Nicely played across. Babb is the man who keeps it alive, coming up, knocks it in the air, then it's drifted in, and Cascarino reacts quickest.
Tony Cascarino, the most capped player in Irish soccer history, has confessed he was ineligible to play for the Republic. The grandparents' rule, which allowed Cascarino to collect 88 international caps in the green jersey, did in fact not exist.
It's in his forthcoming autobiography that the former Irish international revealed that his mother was adopted and therefore the link with his Irish grandmother didn't exist. He says he was only told by his mother 4 years ago. Today the FAI said it was embarrassed if even inadvertently it had played an illegible player going back to the 80s, but said since 1996 this could no longer happen since all players over 15 now had to carry an Irish passport.
Prior to 1996, really I think it was a matter of the player confirming to the FAI officials of the time, most verbally, that he was qualified and whatever. But in 1996, FIFA and UEFA indicated to all associations that not alone should you be happy that they are eligible, but you should actually produce the passport.
And personally, it's a difficult thing for him. But I think he was, in spirit, an Irishman. And within the spirit of the laws, I think he was qualified to play for us.
The FAI's chief executive, Bernard O'Byrne, says he doesn't think there's a feeling around that the FAI should start recalling Tony Cascarino's caps and make what is essentially a personal matter worse. He said that the former Irish international had been a great servant to Irish football and he hoped to discuss the matter with them later this week. Deirdre McCarthy, RTE News, FAI headquarters in Dublin.